Good evening, Kensington Temple. Welcome to our Wednesday prayer night. Who is ready to pray in here today? Who is ready to storm, to move the hand of God? Who is ready to see lives changed? What about you joining us right now at home? Posture yourselves. Are you ready? Isaiah 55:11. Isaiah 55:11 says, "So is my word that goes out from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but will accomplish what I desire and achieve the purpose for which I sent it." When God's word goes out from his mouth, he says it will not return to him empty. What it has been sent forth to do, his word will do. Are we ready to command his word tonight? Are we ready to receive, accept, and allow his word to work in us this evening? Then in the house, when you're ready, please stand. And at home, as I've said, take your posture, for the Lord is here. And we will be blessed this evening. For me, come and lead us into his presence. Amen.
Good evening, Kensington Temple. Amen. Can we just lift up our hands and begin to thank him? Just give him worship in the room, give him praise in the room. We're going to bless his holy name tonight. Just lift up your voice and begin to thank him for what he's going to do in our midst tonight. Just rightly, as Pastor Colette has said, that even as we worship, that as we lift our voices, that the glory belongs to Jesus tonight. And the blessings will be ours tonight. Amen. Amen. Come on, let's clap our hands.
Glorious. Shout it out. Shout your name, Jesus, we make your praise glorious. You are glorious. Oh, God, you are glorious.
Can we sing together?
My God.
Shout your name, Jesus, we make your
worship in the room. Lord, we bless your name. We declare,
we say,
shine, Jesus, you shine for all the world to see that you are glorious. Can you join us and say, shine, Jesus, shine, Jesus, you shine for all the world to see that you are glorious, that you are glorious. Oh, 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 God, you are glorious.
Can we do that again? Declare all, say,
the world will bow down and say you are God. Every man will bow down and say you are King. So let's start right now. Why would we wait? Just wanna be with you. I just wanna be with you. Sing, yes, the world.
Hallelujah.
Sing out.
Addiction starts to break, declaring there is hope and there is freedom. I speak Jesus. Your name is power. Your name is healer. Your name is life.
Come on, Katie. Jesus. Let's declare together. Say, Jesus.
Ness over every enemy.
Say,
Jesus.
Say,
shout Jesus from the mountains.
break every stronghold, break every stronghold, shine through the shadows, burn like fire. Your name, say, your name is power, your name is power, your name is healing,
your name is power.
Oh yeah, break every stronghold.
Take 30 seconds and begin to just declare the name of Jesus. Take authority over every stronghold in the room, over every addiction in this place, over every sickness in this room. We declare the name of Jesus. The Bible says that at the mention of that name, every knee has to bow. So sickness has to bow. Depression has to bow. Anxiety has to bow. In the name of Jesus. Come on, declare the name of Jesus in the room. Begin to cry out the name of Jesus over every circumstance, over every situation, over everything. Declare right now the name of Jesus that heals, that saves, that delivers. You have the power. The Bible says life and death is in the power. In the name of Jesus. We call the name of Jesus over our minds, over our family, over our loved ones. We cry out that name in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. For there is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus.
Your name is power. Your name is healing.
Your name is power.
Break every stronghold. Break every stronghold. Shine through the shadows. Burn like fire.
One more time, one more time. Break every stronghold. Your name.
Situation in the room, we break every stronghold, shine through the shadows, burn light.
Can we just cry out the name of Jesus and declare,
for there is power in the name of Jesus.
To break every chain, to break every chain.
to break every chain, to break every chain, to break every chain.
Come on, declare it. There is power, say,
there is power in the name of
Jesus.
We know what the power is. Say, there is power in the name of
Jesus.
There is power, there is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break.
Jesus, call the name of Jesus over your circumstance, over your lives right now, over every circumstance you're facing. Call that name of Jesus. That name is a deliverer. That name is a deliverer in this room tonight. God, we call on your name, Jesus. We call upon the name Jesus tonight.
Jesus, 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 Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus, 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 Jesus. We call on your name tonight. We call on the name that is mighty to save. We call on the name that is mighty to heal. We call on the name that is mighty to deliver, strong to deliver. We call on the name that causes demons to flee. We call on the name that raises the dead. We call on the name that opens the blind eyes. We call on the name of Jesus, for he is exalted above every other name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let us be expectant tonight. Let us be expectant that Jesus is in this place. For where two or three are gathered in his name, there he is. Where he is lifted up, he draws all men unto him. So let us be expectant, not for the coming of Jesus in his second coming, but his appearing, his revelation, his power here tonight. Amen. Give the Lord a praise one more time as we rejoice in his goodness. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We bless your name, O God. You may take your seats in the house of the Lord. I don't say this out of cliche, but God is good all the time. Amen. We are having an awesome time in his presence, and be encouraged to be expectant tonight. Amen. We have a few things going on this week and this month, if it's okay to just share those with you before we continue. This Sunday, we continue with an amazing Blessed Time 9 a.m. service, 11 a.m. service. We will be having Pastor Lincoln from Liberty Community Center sharing with us. So Lincoln Sewanga from Liberty Christian Fellowship. And at 6 p.m., we will continue with the series of the I Am. Amen. Parents-to-be, Saturday the 13th of April, that's this coming Saturday, we have the Parents-to-be Ministries continuing to gather together, and that will be in person. And that will be from 3 till 5 p.m. So if you are in the Parents-to-be Ministry, if you are a parent or a couple who desire to be parents, if you want to find out about family and well-being, please do come for that event. Christian Essentials, the next module has started, or the next series. So that's a three-week course where new believers come together, new to the faith come together. And for 3 weeks, we are finding out, who is this Jesus? Why believe in the Bible? What is the church?
the roots, the ground, the foundation of our faith. And after those 3 weeks, many desire to be baptized. So we will be having the baptism service on the 28th of April. So if you've not been water baptized and you would like to be, the Christian Essential Course is a good one to get connected with. 7 p.m. in the lower hall on a Tuesday. Yesterday was our first one, and we had a beautiful turn up and also the presence of God. I see some people smiling because they were there. We had an awesome time in God's presence as well as in learning the word. Next week is the last time to come in. So if you want to come into these 3 weeks, next week is the last chance to join. And then after that, you'd have to wait till the next one. Okay? All right, the next one, IBIOL and Regents Bible School have collaborated and they have different modules going on. The next one has started as well, so that's Spirit-Empowered Discipleship or Spirit-Empowered Disciples. It started yesterday, it's here in KT on a Tuesday in the upper hall, that's where we are now. If you would like to join, you still have time. Next week is the last opportunity to register. And you find out, again, how do I, in the 21st century, be an empowered Christian? Amen. An empowered disciple, like I read in the Bible. So that is really an exciting time. We have exam preparations, as you know, GCSEs, A-levels, and a few other important exams take place in the springtime leading up to summertime. So if you are a teacher or you are in education or you know someone who is and would like to help the young people get ready for their exams, please connect with us. The details are info@kt.org. Register or rather write to us and just say, hi, I'm a teacher, or hi, I'm interested. Give us your phone number as well at least and let us be able to connect with you. We'll have a group come together and see how we can get the young people to do well in their exams. Sounds like a good plan? Okay, excellent. Last but not least, this Friday, 7 p.m., do we know what's happening? The Watoto Children's Choir will be here. It's going to be exciting. It is free of charge. Do arrive on time to get a seat. Do invite neighbors. Do invite family and friends. It's going to be really awesome. And we're just going to watch a quick video before we continue.
Guys, not done with you yet.
Stronger than 10,000 armies. I'm looking forward to this Friday night. Make sure as many of you as can come will come. So this evening, in my heart was the words, "This is our God." Last week, I think that Pastor Corin took us through something from Ephesians about who we are, our identity in Christ. We had a little bit from Ephesians as well on Sunday with Pastor Harold. But it was as if the Lord was impressing upon me on Monday evening, who am I? I am He. I can't express it or say it any other way. So I'm going to do something as led. That's as much as I could say. The first thing I want you to do, please, and at home, is just close your eyes. Just voices only when you're ready to join me. Worthy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Worthy is your name. praise. Worthy is your name. Worthy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Worthy is your name. Worthy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Worthy, are you worshiping him? Oh, worthy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Worthy is your name. Worthy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Worthy is your name. What a healing Jesus I found in you. What a healing Jesus you restore, refresh, and renew. What a healing Jesus for such a time as this. Arise on healing wings, Son of righteousness. Sometimes it's a good thing when some of the pastors can sing as well, isn't it? What are you sensing? Where did that take you? Are your eyes on Jesus Christ? Are your eyes on his power, on his worth? Are your eyes on what he can do? What a healing Jesus I found in you. Are your eyes fixed that he's worthy? Why is he worthy? Why is his name worthy? Who is this our God? This is our God. Worthy of praise. Worthy to be adored. Worthy to be lifted up. This is our God who brings his healing power. Who brings his delivering power. Who brings us out of circumstances that are difficult. Who sets us on high places. This is our God. You can do anything if you want to come and kneel, if you want to lay on the carpet, if you want to get on your knees where you are. Take your posture and begin to bring to the Lord all of those circumstances that are not from him. Bring to him the bondage you may be in. Bring to him the diseases that may be in your body that you don't want. Bring to him the financial strain and situation that you may be in. Bring to him the family difficulties that are keeping you apart from one another. Bring to him the stresses of your working day. Bring to him every aspect of your life. Where you're hurting, where you're desperate, where you can't see a way out, where you don't know what the answer is. Jeremiah 23, verse 29 says, "Is not my word like fire, declares the Lord, and like a hammer that breaks a rock in pieces?" What rock is in your life that the word of God can begin to break in pieces right now? Bring it to the Lord. Bring it to the Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, let this word penetrate. Is not my word like fire and like a hammer that breaks a rock in pieces? Begin to break those circumstances down in the lives of your children. Begin to break them down like a hammer, Lord. Break them in pieces, whether it be sickness, whether it be health problems, whether it be mental health issues, whether it be financial issues, whether it be family issues, whether it be work issues, whether it be what's my future, whether it be are you real, whether it be anything that we could think or imagine. Break with your word. Is not your word like fire? Isaiah 55, verse 11. So is my word, as I read earlier on, that goes out from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but it will accomplish what I desire and achieve the purpose for which I sent it. Begin to declare that word of God in your circumstances. Declare it and say that God will accomplish his word. God will set you free. God will deliver. God will turn it around for you. Begin to declare, Lord, so is your word that goes out from your mouth. It won't return to you empty. Your word will accomplish what you have desired. It will achieve its purpose. It will do what it's sent to do. Now do in my life what your word is sent to do.
Brother Felix, come and lay hands on this gentleman.
My brother Ian, you know that God hears every cry and every word that you cry, every prayer you pray. You know that God understands you. And don't think for one second that this is your lot in life, for you will see change. You will see healing. You will see a difference in your life and freedom. In the name of Jesus, so shall the word of God go forth from his mouth. It will not return empty, but it will accomplish that which it sent forth to do in Ian's life. In the name of Jesus Christ. Ishkirama. Psalm 139, verse 4. Before a word is on my tongue, Lord, you know it completely. Before we even begin to pray, before we even begin to speak, before we even begin to say, the Lord already knows what we want to ask, what we need. He already knows. Psalm 119, verse 28. My soul is weary with sorrow. Strengthen me according to your word. Are you picking these things up? The word of God strengthens us. Begin to ask him now to strengthen you. Let his word give you strength in your situation. Let his word lift you up in your situations. Begin to ask him. My soul is weary with sorrow. Strengthen me according to your word. Zechariah 4, verse 6. So he said to me, this is the word of the Lord to Zerubbabel, not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord Almighty. It's not our strength. It's not what we have in our flesh that makes the difference. It is by the Spirit of God that change comes. So ask him right there where you are. Spirit of God, come afresh in my life. For no might nor power can do this, but your spirit is at work in my circumstance, in my situation. Jeremiah 1, verse 12, the Lord said to me, you have seen correctly, for I am watching to see that my word is fulfilled. If God is watching to see when we declare his word that it is fulfilled, begin to declare it over your lives. I want the worship team back, please. Begin to declare it over your lives. Begin to declare it over your lives. What word do you need? The Lord says in one of the scriptures, since you are precious in my sight, do you just need to know that he loves you and that you are precious? In another scripture, the Lord talks about the mind. I have the mind of Christ. Is that the word that you need? That you have the mind of Christ and not the mind of the enemy. What is it that you should begin to declare from God's word that he will watch over? We're going to minister a couple of songs, and during this time, I want you to continue to talk to God, to meet with God, to petition God, to ask God. He's holy forever. Hallelujah. Shikabiara baso. Rebe kiriyama baba soberebe.
Falling down in worship to sing a song of vengeance to the Lamb. And all have gone before us, and all sing a song of ages to the your name is the highest, your name is the greatest, your name stands above them all thrones and dominions, all powers and positions.
If you walk in freedom, if you bear his name, we'll sing a song forever to the Lamb.
We'll sing a song. You are lifted up, oh.
Are you still commanding? Are you still applying that word to your life? Are you still moving so that the word of God is working in your life? Declaring and letting that word do what it sent forth to do. And I will fall at your feet. I will fall at your feet. And I will worship you. Just tap in a little bit longer. Remember, you're making the word work for you. So God, your grace is enough, more than I need. At your word, I will believe. I wait for you. Draw near again. Let your spirit make me.
Spirit, I am free,
and
I will fall.
evening, set a seal upon every declaration made by every son and daughter in this house tonight. Set a seal on your word working in their lives, and let them testify of your victory. They're at home, Lord. You have presenced yourself with your people. Surround them and set a seal, and let them boast of your victory in their lives, in Jesus' name. Amen. Lilies, thank you.
Thank you, Pastor Claudette. You may have your seats for a moment. We're just going to continue in the spirit of prayer and intercession as we come to our giving. Amen. In Matthew chapter 28, Jesus said in verse 18, "All authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things that I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the age." Amen. We are standing on the words of Jesus where he says, "All authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth." And so in his name, we go forth in his authority. Amen. But the verse after that, "Go, therefore, into all the nations." That takes logistics. That takes planning. That takes people. That takes resources. Amen. So when you and I come to this place of giving like we're about to do now, we're actually stepping into the Great Commission. Today, it might not be me who goes to the mission field outside the country, but somebody will be going because I have given. Amen. Today, it might not be me who's downstairs preparing the food hub, but someone is going to be able to do that because I have given. And so together, we are going into the mission. Amen. And as I was reading this today, I really felt, Lord, there are so many of us who could be giving, but yet there's restrictions in our finances. Break that restriction in Jesus' name. And so as we come to the place of giving, you can give by envelope, which you found on your seat. You can give electronically. You can give online. If you're here for the first time, there's no obligation to give. But if you are willing and you're ready, you are welcome to do so. But we're going to pray for finances. Is that okay? We're going to pray for the people we know, either in this room or our friends, our family, who need a job. Amen? If you know anyone who needs a job, or if you are someone who needs a job, please stand up. If you're online, join in faith. If you know someone or you are someone, and we're going to pray for that. Because we need to be able to send, and we can only send when the Lord provides. Let's stretch out our hands to whoever is in this room standing. Anyone standing next to you, believe in the Lord for a job. Father God, it is your word that tells us to go forth into all the world. And Father God, it is the resources that come from you. And you've blessed us with jobs and businesses to be able to do that. And so we ask in the name of Jesus for jobs for our brothers and sisters, those standing, those that they represent, those watching us online, those that we know of. Let jobs be open unto them now in the name of Jesus. Let every limitation be removed that has hindered them, that has hindered us from stepping into employment in the name of Jesus. Let the crooked paths be made straight according to your word in the name of Jesus Christ. That, dear God, we shall use our hands, and we ask that you would bless the work of our hands in Jesus' name. So we thank you for the testimonies that will be coming in of jobs provided, of incomes coming into families and into homes, dear God, so that they may have food. They may have food in their own houses, and they may have for giving into the house of the Lord in the name of Jesus Christ. And all God's people say, amen. And we're all going to pray together. Let us stand up. Whatever your situation is, let us ask the Lord to equip us to complete and to fulfill that great commission in a higher dimension than we've been doing. Amen? So let us lift up our hands. Father, we thank you. We thank you for jobs and businesses. We thank you for incomes. We thank you that you are the God who provides one way or another. We have seen your goodness. We have seen your faithfulness. We have seen your loving kindness. And in the name of Jesus Christ, we speak life over every single financial situation in this house. Even that which is blessed, let it go to a new level of blessing in the name of Jesus, that there may be overflow to bring into your house, overflow to fulfill your commission, dear God, your commission that requires resources, dear God. And so we speak your blessing over every single one here, and even over those watching online, and all of it for your glory and for your praise. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
God, I look to you. I won't be overwhelmed. Give me vision to see things like you do. And God, I look to you. You're where my help comes from. Give me wisdom, 'cause you know just what to do.
See things like
Beautiful. Thank you. Beautiful. Hallelujah. We just thank God for our worship team and the different people that are part of it, who are ministering to us on Wednesday evenings and on Sundays. Remarkable and fantastic. Thank you so much. Are we ready to do some more praying? Each week we may pick an area and then I say, let's not stop. Take it home. Continue to pray. Sometimes we're praying for our youth, for the youth on the streets of London. Sometimes we're praying for different nations, and I say, let's not stop. We continue. We remember those things that we've asked God for, and we continue in prayer. Tonight, we're going to have a little bit of a focus on missions and prisons, and we have some great ministries here in Kensington Temple. So we have Michelle Bennett, who is all things learning, and our principal of IBIL at the moment, and she's going to come up and pray shortly. But first of all, Marco, whose surname I don't know why I can't say when you've been on staff for so many years. Please come. Marco's going to lead us in a couple of prayer areas for things that are coming up in the future. And the first one is very soon. But we really want to pray and then keep hold of the things we ask him for tonight and continue to push in prayer. So come and let us know what you're doing, Marco. Thank you.
We will be praying primarily for our prison ministry. But because of what Lily said about our giving, I thought, because this coming week, we'll be sending some money to Lebanon, to a church that's entirely consisting of converts. I just want to thank you for that. Let me just read from this. This is from brother of Usama, who is looking after hundreds of converts from Islam. And when he heard the news that we are able to give to them from this church, from your money, he said, hallelujah, this is truly amazing news and an amazing day. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, and thank you for your efforts. So I'm passing this on to you because I feel like I get all the thanks from the people over there, and it's not my money, it's your money. So, but please pray for Brother Usama as well and for his family as we are embarking on some new missions. But today, we are going to Scrubs prison on Sunday with a team of 16. And there are quite a few team members in this room right now. So why don't you stand up and why don't we want to, I mean, haven't you experienced the great presence of God here today? And we want to have the life-transforming presence of God with us as we go out there on Sunday, and also just have a very strong witness. So why don't we just get up? I've seen quite a few others here. There is Felix, there's Emmanuel, there is, so why don't we just get, and Victor, you can see everybody here. So why don't we just gather around the people who are going on Sunday and just bless them today? We really want to see the power of God. We've seen, and one of the most amazing things is the worship in that place when we go in. In 5 minutes, the atmosphere changes. And we want to pray for the worship team, and there are worship team members here as well. So let's just pray and just release the presence of God. Oh, Heavenly Father, we thank you for your goodness and your grace, Lord. You have given us hope, and you have restored our soul. And you're still doing that in our lives, Lord. But we're going to go to a place where normally we get about 80 inmates come to chapel services, and we just want to see transformed lives in that place, Lord. We pray, Father, for your Holy Spirit to lay hold of us and lay hold of all of those inmates coming, and we rebuke every interruption, any disturbance in that place on Sunday. We just pray for 4 good services where you need service. Your presence would flow, and that those inmates who come in there would come in maybe in despair, but go out transformed in Jesus' name. Release your presence, Lord, we pray. Release your presence over us. Give us hope. Give us joy. Give us such a smile, Lord, that even from that smile on our face, people's life would be transformed and full of hope in Jesus' name. Lord, we thank you for what you are to us and who you are to us. And we pray that you'll be the same Savior, the same Deliverer to every person who comes into that chapel on Sunday. And we pray that you would expand that ministry into the cells, Lord, that even those people who don't come to the chapel on Sunday, they would hear the good news from their inmates. Thank you for the baptisms that have taken place in that church, in the chapel over the last year, Lord. Thank you for each one of those inmates who have been baptized. And we thank you for your goodness over their lives today. And we pray that we would hear testimonies of transformation and chains in Jesus' name. Amen.
That prisoners have been already born again or won and baptized, is that correct?
Yeah, there have been quite a few baptized.
Quite a few of the prisoners have been baptized.
Last 6 months, there was about 9 baptized.
Wow. You know, we really need to thank God for those lives. And just before Marco moves on to the next prayer line, I felt that we need to cry out for the salvation of these inmates in the prison when they go this Sunday. So let's cry out together. Let's just ask the Lord to bring more salvation in that prison, in those services, in that chapel, in the name of Jesus, so that testimony is there of salvation again. Father, in the name of Jesus, we stand with Marco and the team going in on Sunday. We speak life. We send forth your word. Bring salvation to these inmates. Bring a changed life to them, Lord, like you have done for 9, but give an abundance of salvation, that the day will come when the whole prison has turned to you, Lord Jesus, and we can rejoice. Bring them into your kingdom in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray. Amen and amen. Amen.
A second point of prayer for prisons, or actually a detention center. We have been invited to go to visit the Heathrow Detention Center a couple of weeks from here. And I met with the lead chaplain, and they're really wanting us to go there and minister. I mean, it's probably even more desperate place than the Scrubs, because most of these people who are there, they'll be sent overseas from wherever they came to. And they are on their way out. They all have their lawyers, and some of them stay, but about 70% of them normally are going to be sent. They will be on the plane any time soon. So we just want to sort of bring that to you as a church, because we can engage with many things, but actually this is not my effort. This is not the prison ministry team. This is our church. And just for discernment, is this something that we should be doing? I do feel symbolically that he's your being, I think it's the third busiest airport in the world, and us being one of the most international churches in the world, there is a connection there where, in one sense, us being this kind of church and most of these people there who are they are coming from overseas, they're sent back. So they represent the nations, we represent the nations. So we should pray for that. Let's pray for that detention center, because it's actually quite a hard job to be there when you know that you are ministering hope in very difficult circumstances. So, and also when we go there, that God would show us whether that's something that we need to do. But let's pray for those hopeless people in that place, where, I mean, you hear stories about those centers where people take their lives. They're very desperate. So let's pray for that place. There were 700 detainees in that place, I think, right now, roughly. There's a lot of people being sent back from the UK. And but also please pray for discernment for us. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord. When it even says about Abraham, that he was, when he came to, he was a wanderer. He was not a refugee, but he was an alien. He was an outsider. He was somebody who was traveling from one country to another. And these people in that place, Lord, there are Christians, there are non-Christians, there are Muslims, there are people from every religion and of none, Lord. We just pray, Lord, that your grace will be manifested in that place in your name, Lord. That we pray especially for the team of the chaplains and volunteers who work there day to day and try to bring hope to people who are in a very hopeless place, Lord. And Heavenly Father, we pray for this church. We pray for discernment for ourselves, Lord, for this church to see whether that's something that we should be doing in the future. In Jesus' name, we just pray that you open our eyes, Lord. And Father, we just pray that as we go there in a few weeks' time, Lord, that you would show us if this is something that we need to do in future, in Jesus' name. Thank you for your goodness. We experience that goodness. We experience your grace. We are not there to pass judgment on people, but we just want to see your grace manifested in that place, and we pray for that to happen in Jesus' name. Amen. And next we have Michelle. She'll be leading us on a short-term mission.
Well, I find few things more exciting than being on the front line of where we're pushing back the kingdom of darkness and where God's kingdom is expanding. So if you have anything to do with our training department, you'll end up being pushed out onto the front line somehow. But we're going to pray for the Mission Centre in Marseille. We're taking a team there in July. We're going to start by praying for the Mission Centre. And have my Bible verse, please, Taiwo. Praising God and having favour with all the people, the Lord added to their number, day by day, those who are being saved. That's Acts 2:47. The centre there, it's in the poorest part of Marseille, where there's lots of immigrants from North Africa. So that's a lot of people from another faith who are in the immediate area. But there are three congregations that meet there. A Madagascan one, an Ethiopian one, and a Romanian congregation, as well as regular prayer and worship and stuff like that. And there's opportunity to operate from the centre with community projects. There's a charity who are breaking the cycle of drug addiction and gang warfare in the area, and other social community projects. So we're going to start by praying for Jean-Hugues and that centre. So we're going to take the first part. The verse is gone. This part is verse. Having favour with all the people. So we're going to pray for favour. So I'm going to ask you to stand to your feet. Now I'm going to ask you to turn towards the corner kind of over there, because that's southeast. That's roughly where Marseille is. So why don't you stretch your hands towards Marseille and start to pray God's favour on the work in Marseille. Father, we pray for your favour on Jean-Hugues, who's been working and plugging away in the city of Marseille for nearly 20 years. Father, we thank you for this breakthrough. We pray for favour on him. Father, we pray for favour on this centre, that the doors will open and that the local population and the immigrant population from North Africa, people of other faiths, people of no faith, that they will find favour as they walk in through the door. Father, we pray for favour upon the charity that's breaking the cycle of drug addiction. Father, we pray that your favour will fall and the local authorities will provide everything they need. They will provide money. They will provide the correct regulation. They will allow them to do what you're calling them to do in the third arrondissement in Marseille, Father. And we pray for your kingdom to break out in its power in the poorest part of that city. Father, pour favour on the city in Marseille. And from the second part of that verse, as the favour falls, we pray that people will be added to your kingdom in that place. Father, we pray for salvation to break out in the poorest part of Marseille. Father, we pray that as people come and they find healing, they find restoration, they find help for their family, they find their young men and young women pulled out of gangs. They find their needs met. They find their families fed. They find a worshiping, loving community there. Father, we pray that they will say, add me to those people. That they will be crying out to be added to your kingdom. Father, we pray for favor of salvation in Marseille in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Thank you very much. Well, does that sound exciting? Do you want to be there? Well, we are taking a team in July. In July. It's in your revival times. So all the details are there. I'm not advertising it, but you can come. There's freedom to come with us. And I've got a verse for this as well. It's actually one that I'm going to be teaching those of you on the Tuesday night school. You'll be hearing this one a bit more. 1 Peter 4:10, as each has received a gift, use it to serve one another as good stewards of God's varied grace. So as we've all, everyone, even though you might not recognize it, you've been given gifts by God, by his grace, to use for one another. So we're taking a team on the 8th of July. And we want to draw together the team that God's calling into that place. So I've got four things to pray. People be released to join the team. Now, I know there's people who want to be on the team, and they need a massive breakthrough to be on the team. So begin to pray for them. And if that's you, you know who you are. Confidence, for those who've never been involved in missions before, that the mix of people will be right, and to be and for the team to be used for God's glory. So why don't you stand up, look at two or three of your neighbors. You don't have to lay hands on them or anything like that. Just stand up and look at your neighbors and begin to pray for their gift to be encouraged and for them to step out in what God's called them to do. And when you do that, you'll be being prayed for. And then if you think, it could be me going to Marseille, you know what to do. So let's just pray. Father, we thank you for our brothers and sisters. We thank you for one another. Father, as we look at each other, Father, we thank you that we are looking at people gifted by you. Father, we thank you that the person I'm looking at has been gifted by you. And Father, we pray that you will rise up a team of people gifted by you to be part of the Breakthrough Week in Marseille. Father, we pray that giftings that people never knew they had will come to the fore. Boldness that people never knew they had would rise up within them, Father. And Father, we pray, pull together the team that you want for this mission in Marseille for this day. Father, it's 1 week, and Lord, we trust you to pull together the people that you want us to take on that time, and everything that would stand in the way of your team going to Marseille, Father, we pray that it would be broken now in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray that supernatural changes will come into people's lives that will free them to be part of this mission team. Father, help us to take the team from Kensington Temple, London City Church, that you want us to take. May nobody be held back, but may there be many people on that team who discover they're gifted in you. And Father, we just open our eyes and look at the brothers and sisters around us and say, thank you for the giftings in this room. Father, use them for your grace and your glory in Marseille and across the world. Amen.
Hallelujah. Bless you, Michelle. Thank you so very much for those prayers. And thank you, Marco. Keep praying for the prison ministry. Pray for whether we do join and do some works with the detention center. And also pray for Mission Marseille, where more details will be given. Amen. Jordan's going to come back and just play a little bit for me. We're just going to have a time of ministry. I'm going to invite Pastors Jacqueline Brown and Lilies to the platform. We're just going to minister about healing, physical healing, mental healing, emotional. We just want to spend a few minutes ministering into your lives. I've asked Jacqueline to come and really stand in the gap for those who are suffering with cancer. You might know somebody, or it might be you. And she's going to really pray. I have a scripture because I didn't even prepare her, but she'll have her own as well. And if the spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead is living in you, he who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies because of his spirit who lives in you. That's Romans 8:11. But go ahead, Jacqueline. Bless you.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Shandalama. Everyone speak in other tongues. Brondalaba kariya brokadaba saya. Roba kite bro. Kita so telebe. Rekedebo shabababai. Brondalaba kai. If you're suffering with cancer, I want you to put your hand up. Or if you know somebody suffering with cancer, put your hand up. Because God is a healer. He still heals people today. Brokadabasaya, Robakadaya, Rokadabase, Rekedeboshe, Robababakurieya, Rekede Broka, Brokadabasaya, Brengedebosha. Father, we take authority. Roba kadako, brekedebese, roba kaya, kutaseke. We take authority over the spirit of death. Brokadabaseya, rekedebosaya. Every pronouncement that they've made, that the person's going to die or they've only got this much time. Lord God, we take authority because your word says that you are the spirit of resurrection. You're the spirit of life. We break every spirit of death in the name of Jesus. We break the spirit of death in the name of Jesus. We break the spirit of death off of every individual that has been pronounced, given a death sentence. We break it in Jesus' name. We break death. We rebuke the spirit of death in the name of Jesus. I rebuke the spirit of death in Jesus' name. It is a spirit. And so we rebuke you in the name of Jesus. We say you shall not die, but you shall live to declare the works of the Lord. You shall testify of deliverance. In the name of Jesus, we rebuke that demon in Jesus' name. The works of God is so that the power of life shall be seen in the earth. You came so we would have life and life abundantly. And so in the name of Jesus, every person that is suffering from the spirit of cancer, in the name of Jesus, we rebuke you, devil, in Jesus' name. And we speak life and healing and wholeness, hope, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Wow.
Hallelujah. Give Jesus praise because he's doing it right now. He's doing it right now. He's doing it. Clap like you believe. He's doing it right now.
Hallelujah. Just Jacqueline was praying as well. I just kind of heard that people have vision problems in the house, vision problems at home online. If you have vision problems and you're looking for the Lord to heal, then place your hands over your eyes and let's begin to pray about those conditions. In my right eye, there is partial vision. And I have to go to the hospital every few months. I've had a series of 11 injections, which was caused by a burst blood vessel. It took some of my sight. And over the years, it got worse. And there was a day when they were so concerned because I had 22% vision in my right eye. So they were booking for me to go and have another injection. And I didn't want any more. And there was, on the God Channel, there was a program and a minister who I actually know, who they were having like an hour, you know, where they pray for the sick. And I sent an email in, which was responded to straight away. And a word was spoken over my life. And when I went that afternoon, my vision had increased by 66%. Place your hands over your eyes if you want the Lord to heal you. And then believe for his healing power. Whether, Lord, tonight you improve or completely heal, I break the power of the spirit of blindness in the name of Jesus. Whatever diseases might cause it, whether it's what I had, or whether it is diabetes or any other disease, I come against it. The causes of glaucoma, pressure behind the eyes in the name of Jesus Christ. And I speak the healing power of Jesus Christ over people's sight today in your precious holy name. Hallelujah. And if keep believing the Lord for your healing. Keep believing.
We give you praise, oh God. We thank you for you are moving in this place, oh God. We thank you, Jesus, for you are the one who walked on this earth and you touched and people were healed, oh God. So we continue to believe in your name, oh God, for every sickness, every disease, everything named in this room today be healed in the name of Jesus Christ by the stripes of Jesus that he bore 2,000 years ago, by the blood of Jesus that he shed 2,000 years ago. We are healed and we declare life. We declare life over every organ, life over every organ system. We command regeneration where regeneration is needed in the name of Jesus. Lord Jesus, we ask for new body parts where they are needed in the name of Jesus Christ, because there is nothing impossible for you, oh God. Come and do what only you can do. And Lord, we stretch out our hearts and our hands and in faith to those watching online. Church, if we could just lift up our hands and stretch them forward, and the camera will catch it for those watching online. Father, we pray for those who are in bed at this time and they cannot get out of their beds because of one reason or another, sickness and disease. We rebuke every infirmity in the name of Jesus. Every curse is canceled because the blood of Jesus has been shed. In the name of Jesus Christ, receive your healing. Legs, receive your strength. Paralysis, be removed in the name of Jesus Christ. Sciatica, be gone in the name of Jesus Christ. Strength, disc problems, be healed in the name of Jesus. Neck disc problems, be healed in the name of Jesus. Spine problems, be healed in the name of Jesus who created you. Be healed now. We give you praise, oh God, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Go ahead.
Anyone suffering from arthritis? Anyone suffering from arthritis? Anyone suffering from arthritis? God wants to heal you. Make sure you forgive. Make sure you forgive. Arthritis and rheumatism. Anyone suffering from arthritis and or rheumatism, God wants to heal you tonight. Tonight, tonight, tonight. Anyone suffering from that in this room? Come forward, come forward, come forward. We're going to just pray over you. Just, we want you to raise up your faith because God is a healer. Claudette heard this as well, arthritis. Arthritis or rheumatism. You must forgive though, you must forgive. Have you forgiven, my darling? Have you forgiven? Yes? Have you forgiven, my darling? Have you forgiven? Have you forgiven? Have you forgiven? Have you forgiven? Yes? Have you forgiven? Okay, forgive, forgive whoever. Forgiven? I believe that God really wants to heal arthritis. I remember there was somebody that got prayed for with arthritis and their hand was all screwed up like that. The moment they forgave, their hand just came out. So I believe that God wants to heal you. Jeremiah 30 and verse 17 says, "But I will restore you to health and heal your wounds, declares the Lord, because I don't need to go to the next bit. I will restore your health and heal your wounds." Everybody pray in tongues. Brokadabasaya, rekedebosha, brondadabakaya, rekedebese, robababai, brokadabasaya, rokadabasu. Come forward to the altar. Come forward to the altar. Rokadabasirie, rengedebosa, rokadabasaya, brondadabakaya, rokadabasuya, rekedebesirie, robababai. Ronda la bakariye ya, reke de basuriye ya, roba baba bakuriye ya, rika la bosa, broka la basaya, breke de basuriye, roka la basia, ronda la bakariye. In the realm of the spirit, broka la basata kabo. We take authority over the spirit of infirmity that has attached itself to these people,
and has given them arthritis in their body. In the name of Jesus, Brokalabasaya, Brekelebosaya, Rokalabasaya, Rebebebebe. Everyone speak in tongues. Let me feel the tongues. Let me feel the spirit. Rokalabasaya. We together are breaking every spirit of infirmity, every spirit of arthritis, every spirit of pain, where people are filled with pain. In Jesus' name, we rebuke the spirit of pain. We rebuke the spirit of pain. We rebuke the spirit of pain. We rebuke rheumatism. We rebuke the spirit of arthritis. We break your hold. We break your power in the name of Jesus. We break your hold in Jesus' name. 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 We destroy your hold. Let me hear the tongues in this house. We're a Pentecostal church that prays in tongues. And when we pray in tongues, it's mysteries of in the spirit. And so we want the miraculous here today. In the name of Jesus, we break every spirit. We break every spirit. We break every spirit. We break every spirit of arthritis. Go, go in the name of Jesus. Get out in Jesus' name. Spirit of arthritis, go in the name of Jesus. Get out in Jesus' name. We command healing and wholeness and life. Spirit of arthritis, go from these people in the name of Jesus. Go in Jesus' name. Go in Jesus' name. Spirit of arthritis, get out in Jesus' name. Go in Jesus' name. Go in Jesus' name. Let me hear you, church. Pray in other tongues. You and I and Cordef, all of us, we're doing this together. Roba kide brondo, ronda la la dondo die mamai. Spirit of arthritis, go in Jesus' name. Spirit of arthritis, go in Jesus' name. Get out in Jesus' name. Ndaraba kudie, spirit of arthritis, go in Jesus' name. And every rheumatism, go in Jesus' name. Spirits of pain, go in Jesus' name. Go in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Spirits of pain, go in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. We're going to continue for a few minutes praying for people. If there are other illnesses that you have and you want prayer, just for a few minutes, some of us will minister to you. So I want to thank you all there at home online today for joining us. Continue to believe the Lord for your healing, for we haven't forgotten you, but neither has he. Please do come and join us this Friday for Watoto Children's Choir. Come at 7 p.m. and enjoy the ministry that they have, and let's just bless their lives. We look forward to seeing you on Sunday for our 9, 11 and 6 p.m. services. And if you are interested in the parents to be ministry, or you have need in the area of being a parent, there's discussion about family this Saturday. So come and join them. All the information is on our website. May God bless you. I'm going to invite the worship team one more time if they're here to sing. This is amazing grace, I feel. And we will continue to minister for a few more minutes if you need prayer. God bless you. Amen and amen. Thank you so much for joining us. Amen.
is moving on the waters. Who's holding up the moon? Who is peeling back the darks with the burning light of noon? Who is standing on the mount? Who is on the earth below? Who is bigger than the heavens? And the lover of my soul. Sing that one time. Who is moving on the waters? Who is holding up the